This video will discuss how doctor can tell the difference between chlamydia and bacterial vaginosis infection. BV is another name or abbreviation used in the medical community or by doctors for bacterial vaginosis. I'm going to use this abbreviation extensively throughout this video. My name is Dr. SlavaFuzayloff, and I'm a practicing STD doctor at STD Center NY, located in Midtown Manhattan, New York City. I know you have limited time and I value your time. Let's proceed. I have to mention in the beginning that the best and the only definitive way to diagnose both chlamydia and bacterial vaginosis is through testing. This video is for people waiting to be tested or waiting for the test to come back so they can make a correct assumption based on signs and symptoms. So how doctors differentiate between chlamydia and bacterial vaginosis during the visit? We usually consider two things when differentiating between chlamydia and bacterial vaginosis: visual exam and the history of the symptoms. We will go into more detail about each part later, but for now I can briefly say that visual exam is when we look at the vaginal area and check it for redness and swelling and assess the discharge at the same time. History of the symptom is when we go over the causes of the symptoms, how soon they showed up, and how they are changing over time. Before the test results are available, 60% of the preliminary diagnosis come from the visual exam and 40% come from the history. Let's talk about the history of the symptom first. Again, as I mentioned earlier, 40% of the diagnosis come from the history. History of the symptoms consists of three parts: what caused symptoms, how soon did it take for symptoms to appear, and how are symptoms evolving. We will talk about each part of history in detail now. Let's go over the possible causes for both conditions first. Both conditions can be caused by sexual activity. Chlamydia typically occurs only with unprotected contact. It can be receiving oral or genital to genital contact. Any infected secretion, sperm, vaginal fluid, saliva, should come into contact with mucosa for the chlamydia infection to occur. Unlike chlamydia, bacterial vaginosis can be induced by anything that changes the vaginal pH. It can be caused by sexual contact, or it can be caused by non-sexual causes. When bacterial vaginosis is caused by sexual contact, it can be induced by either protected or unprotected contact, unlike chlamydia, which is caused by unprotected sex mainly. During the visit, we briefly go over the non-sexual causes of bacterial vaginosis, such as recent antibiotic use, the recent start of birth control pills with high estrogen level, diabetes, or even pregnancy. Despite the presence of non-sexual causes that I just mentioned, sexual activity is more common cause of bacterial vaginosis or BV, especially with a new partner and when the sex is condomless. It's unclear why this is so. And what is more interesting is that BV is more likely to be contracted through oral sex than genital contact, which is why it is more common among homosexual females. The next part of the history is how soon after sexual contact symptoms appeared. This is a major differentiating factor. So the incubation period is shorter for bacterial vaginosis. Bacterial vaginosis infection symptoms appear within 4 days of sexual activity. Chlamydia symptoms take 2 to 3 weeks to show up. the next part and the last part of the history I want to mention is how symptoms change over time. We are not going to talk about each individual symptom here. We will talk about them later, but how those symptoms are progressing over time. Let's start with bacterial vaginosis. Symptoms begin as an itch and redness of the vaginal opening. Over time, itch and redness might progress, causing the swelling of the vulva and vagina opening, as well as abundant grayish, foul-smelling discharge. Unlike bacterial vaginosis infection, chlamydia causes minimal itching and discharge. The main symptoms of chlamydia is urinary symptoms of burning, increased urgency, and frequency of urination. Chlamydia infection, if left untreated, can lead to painful intercourse, bleeding with sexual activity and between periods, and even pelvic inflammatory disease, which can cause lower abdominal pain and infertility. We just finished the history comparison for both conditions. Now let me compare the visual exam. Again, 60% of the preliminary diagnosis comes from the visual exam of vagina and discharge. Before proceeding to the most important part of this video, I will take a moment asking you for a favor to support our channel by liking this video or subscribing to our channel. So let's return to our topic and compare visual exams for both conditions, BV and chlamydia. The visual exam consists of two parts, vaginal exam and a discharge evaluation. Let's discuss each part separately and in more details. Let's talk about the discharge difference for the two conditions first. Let's start with chlamydia this time. Chlamydia discharge is minimal and very little is produced. And if it is produced, it's very thin and the color is either white or colorless. Bacterial vaginosis discharge is also thin, but the amount produced is significantly more and defined as moderate amount. The color of the discharge is usually gray. The most crucial difference between chlamydia and BV discharge is a smell. Any vaginal discharge can be smelly, but certain conditions are well known to have a specific smell. BV is one of them. It has very distinct fishy smell. This smell is a result of altered pH level in the vagina caused by the interaction between healthy vaginal bacteria and unhealthy bacteria. Again, to summarize the most critical parts of the discharge for two conditions, chlamydia discharge is minimal, thin, colorless, or white. BV produces a moderate amount of discharge that also thin, but gray and foul smelly. The last part that I want to mention in this video is a visual exam of the vagina for both conditions. Let's start with BV. Bacterial vaginosis is defined as vaginitis. It's a bacterial overgrowth that causes inflammation of the outer portion of the vagina. That is the reason we see the redness and swelling of the vulva and vagina opening, as well as more abundant discharge with bacterial vaginosis. Chlamydia infection affects the deeper part of the vaginal or the beginning of the uterus called cervix. Therefore, no significant visible redness and swelling is noticed from the outside, or it's very minimal. That brings us to the end of the video. If you learned something and it was helpful, please remember to give this video the thumbs up, subscribe to our channel. And if you want to share your own experience in the comment section to help others, please do so. Thank you for watching, and until next time.